Hi, my name is Malika Afinan, Essential and More, and under the supervision of Dr. Norafisa Mintibadabidin, my FYP title is Potential of Resident Species as Biofertilizer for Soil Fertility Improvement in Palojenak Oil Palm Plantation. So, the background of this study revolves around oil palm. Why oil palm is important? It has high productivity for cultivation due to its high oil content, efficient use of resource, and oil palm versatility. The location of this study is at Palojenak Oil Palm Plantation, which is one of the Ladang Rakyat Terengganu as Sdn Bhd Oil Palm Plantation in Cheneh, Terengganu. Through soil analysis, it is found that the parameter for oil palm growth is not optimum for oil palm growth. So this results in declining yield of palm oil, and it is required to do soil treatment. And so far, for my study, Bacillus has been shown to improve soil fertility in several research papers for other crops. So, from this map here, you can see that it's in Kemaman. And Palojenak is one of the Ladang Rakyat Terengganu Sdn Bhd Oil Palm Plantation, and it has the worst soil quality among four of the plantation. The issue for the problem of this study is that the overuse of chemical fertilizer and pesticide. The second problem is poor soil management before the next cycle of oil palm replanting. Thus, the aim of this study is to improve soil fertility for Palojenak oil palm plantation. So from here, we can see that there is many soil series of this oil palm plantation. And from here, we can see the red bar. And this red bar indicates the optimum point for each of these parameters. And it can be seen that almost all of them does not reach the optimum amount for oil palm growth. The significance of this study is to reduce the chemical fertilizer usage, and uses biofertilizer as alternative fertilizer, which is more sustainable and environmentally friendly approach towards oil palm plantation. There are three objectives to reach the aim of this study. The first is to identify the best species using molecular approach. Second is to characterize the problematic soil from Palojenak oil palm plantation. And the third is to evaluate the effectiveness of best species for fertility improvement on problematic soil. In the literature review, there are three important aspects that need to be focused on. The first is the oil palm, which is Elias guineensis. The life cycle of oil palm revolves, it is 25 to 30 years in average, with the productive age is 21 to 23 years, and oil palm can start to be harvested around 3 to 4 years after planting. The important part of oil palm in this study is the root system type, which is shallow and adventitious, and it forms dense mat of adventitious root in the top 50 cm of soil. And these are the optimum oil palm soil condition. The second one is Bacillus species. It is a gram-positive bacteria, and its habitat is ubiquitous. It can be found in many type of environment, including the extreme environment. There will be at least one species of Bacillus. Their spore is also high resistant capacity, and they are also motile. So Bacillus species is considered as effective microbe, which is under the category of PGPR, which is plant growth promoting rhizobacteria. So PGPR, as Bacillus is, are able to produce rain through root colonization and retention in rhizosphere. They are able to produce many wide range of products which are able to promote plant growth in general. And then the third one is bacillus species and biofertilizer. Some of the mechanism exhibited by bacillus is nitrogen fixation, phosphate mineralization, nutrient solubilization, and phytohormone production. Some of the examples of bacillus species is bacillus altitudinis, bacillus cereus, and bacillus aryabhattai. For the methods, in general, each objective has its own set of methods to fulfill the objective to reach the aim of the study. The first is to identify bacillus using molecular approach. Two bacillus species are selected for this study. The second objective requires soil sampling, and the third objective requires the production of bacteria granule for soil treatment. So, the detail for objective one, which is molecular approach to identify bacillus, first it is DNA extraction using wizard genome DNA purification kit, and then amplification of DNA by using PCR. Lastly, DNA sequencing using plus at NCI. The second objective is it requires soil sampling at six chosen soil series, which these three are favorable for oil palm growth, and these three are not favorable for oil palm growth. And these six soil series are chosen to compare whether or not bacillus are able to improve the soil fertility for six of these soil series. And as the soil sampling uses soil and auger, pH meter and EC meter. For the third objective, production of bacteria granule is required using kaolin starch powder and bacteria suspension plus sucrose to produce bacteria granule for soil treatment. And then the third one, for objective 2 and 3, soil characterization will be done for both untreated soil and treated soil in order to do soil characterization to obtain the amount of macronutrient and micronutrient in the soil, soil pH and soil EC. So the expected outcome for this study, the first is bacillus species will be identified using a molecular approach. The second, bacillus will enhance the soil fertility. And the third, problematic soil will be characterized and analyzed, and the effectiveness of bacillus will be evaluated for its effectiveness in soil fertility improvement. This is my references. And then for my Gantt chart, this is my Gantt chart. And then so far, what has been done for this study is sampling of the soil and culturing the two bacteria. That's all for me. Thank you.
Next, we will start our Q&A session.
Thank you, Nur Zulaika. Your slides look very formal. Okay, shall we go to your objective part, please?
Is already in the lab. So far it has been identified up to the genus, but not the species.
Okay, so you are going to actually identify at the species level, using the CCS. Okay, so from your readings, okay, there are few of these different types of bacteria that can be used as biofertilizers, right? So what do you think actually these bacteria do in the soil? To make it, I mean, as a biofertilizer.
So, from here, bacillus, they grow through from soil root colonization. So, from the root colonization, they obtain raw material which is not which plants are unable to absorb by its own. But bacillus, BGBR, are able to convert it to a form that are suitable for plants to absorb it easier.
Okay, can you be more specific in terms of what kind of combined during the nitrogen fixation?
Yes, so, atmospheric nitrogen, from atmospheric nitrogen, plants are unable to absorb it by its own, but bacillus are able to convert it to ammonium form, which is easier for plants to absorb it and convert and use it for plant growth.
Okay, besides bacillus, apa lagi bacteria lain yang you can actually use as biofertilizers?
From my reading, there are many.
Penibacillus is quite similar to bacillus, but it's different. Dulu penibacillus tu dia dalam satu bacillus kan? Tapi dia separated. Okay, banyak lagi kan? Sekarang apa tu, apa cyanobacteria,
fungi. Aspergillus also.
Yes. Okay, satu lagi question. So, saya seorang je kan? Saya seorang je penibacillus, saya tanya banyak sikit lah. Okay. Okay, so you intend to actually treat the soil at the quite a big area in the farm, right? So actually, how you actually, you must have a certain area, certain parameter atau certain keluasan yang you want to treat. Because later on you want to actually check whether the fertilizer is working or not. Betul tak? You ada tak actually the idea how big you, the test ataupun the tripod?
The field test will be done in a poly bag.
Okay.
From the sampling here. So each soil series will be taken 3 samples. So from
just now you didn't mention that. I thought you want to treat on the exact. I mean the.
No, we took the sample from each of this plot, and then take it to the lab, and then use the soil. Plant try to treat the soil in a poly bag in the lab, and then check.
Kids lah each. So you have like six soil series, deeper repeated each. Okay, apa lagi nak tanya you? Okay, go back to your method. The method for the accreditation, this one, primers, semua dah ready ke ataupun belum lagi lah?
Dah ready.
So this one you intended to actually identify anti species level. So this one actually is if you want to do a bacteria probe ataupun you need to apply to bacteria too, you have to actually optimize the condition as well in terms of how much you want to repeat. gamble saja?
No.
Do you have any initial plan for that?
There are. So what they are trying to say is how many the amount of powder used for soil treatment.
Like, I mean, the initial culture itself, you have to optimize. Is it that? The bacterial culture just shown. They want bacterial suspension to actually optimize first. Is that? Maybe you tak perlu lagi perform tu. This experiment.
Okay,
bacterial suspension tu berapa banyak yang nak kena tunggu for berapa kilo. It has to be optimized. Berapa lama sebab dia have to be optimized, right?
The bacteria will be cultured for 24 hours.
Yes.
200 milliliter.
200
milliliter of nutrient broth.
Yeah, it's very good for me. So dia kena optimize macam 1 kilo macam nanti nak buat powder tu 1 kilo kan. Berapa banyak bacterial dan suspension tu kena grow. It has to be very optimized later, parameter berapa banyak
bacterial. I think it will be enough for the soil treatment because for each soil treatment, 1 gram of powder
time has end for the Q&A session.
Okay, kita kena tengok tu soil treatment itu adalah parameter yang penting. Yeah, good luck.